All right, so we're back tracking Splinter the rat snake again this morning. It's been about 25 hours since I last tracked him. Oh, I think he might have moved. Yeah, the snake has moved. He's not in the tree anymore.
Guessing this big fat hole.
This big oak over here. Okay, if you guys look over here, you see this big oak with a big hole in it right above the board? That big oak, he was in that tree last night at about 6 o'clock. Okay. Now, if I turn on the radio receiver.
It's the snake.
Hold on. A lot louder over here, so he's moved from that tree to either another tree or he's on the ground. But if you look up in the canopy, there are all these trees are touching, so he doesn't even have to come to the ground to move from tree to tree. He can crawl from tree limb to tree limb just like squirrels do. He can go from one tree to the next without ever touching the ground. And that's possibly what he's done. So we're gonna try to find him.
He could be right above us.
He could be.
Yes.
Oh, he crawls like
yeah.
Of a good song.
He's not very far. He has done some moving just in the last few hours. He might have come out overnight and moved off, or he could be on the move right now and we might find him on the ground. Who knows? What in the world's going on here? Check this out. Somebody dug up a plug of dirt. Don't know what that's for.
Might have been a loo.
Might have been a loo. Here's another one of those plugs of dirt dug up. And circular, very strange. And another one. Could there really be that many loos around here?
They could be.
Here's another one. What in the world? That's really strange.
Huh. Maybe they were putting posts in.
That's, but they're all exactly the same. Maybe it's Sasquatch. Okay, I've switched into attenuator mode, which just means we've gotten really close. And so he's probably somewhere down in here within 100 and 200 feet. Where? Oh, we've got him. He's on the ground, guys. He's. I want everybody to see where he is first. I'm not going to pick him up until... Oh, yeah. Oh, wait, he's moving. I'm going to have to go over and get him because he's going to disappear. So I just want to go, you stay real still. I want to go real slow so we can see him on the video. Here's Splinter, he's on the ground, he's on the move. No, his head's out, I see it. And this is really cool, guys, because this is the first time Splinter has been seen since his release day over a month and a half ago. I'm gonna get a still shot of him. We are gonna have to do the data collection. Okay, I can edit that out. So there's Splinter. First time we've seen him since we released him. He looks good. Looks very healthy, nice and shiny. Let's see if I can see the swelling on his upper lip, because that was an issue with him. It does not look very bad. Looks like it's gone down some. In a minute I will pick him up and we'll give him a good thorough physical. That is one pretty snake, guys. And you guys were here to see him. This is really special because I've taken 4 groups out in the woods over the last month or so to try to find Splinter, and we were never able to see him because he was up in trees. I wonder if he thinks I've got a mouse for him. Because this is a snake, if you guys remember, if anybody ever saw him eat, that when he was in the nature center over the winter, I was able to hand feed him, actually hold a mouse down and he would take it right out of my hand without even any aggressive action or anything. And see, what I'm doing is the data collection. Pictures are very important. It shows what he was doing when I found him. And if you ever work on a scientific project with wildlife, photos, video are going to be very important. All right. Same thing as with the turtles. I've got to get soil temperature and all those things. This is an exciting thing, guys, for me, because this is the first time he's been seen on the ground since we released him. Was anybody there on the release day when we let him go? What did he do? Remember?
He just kind of went into the building. Under it.
Yep.
Just kind of hung out.
Didn't he seem to know where he was?
He did.
And I believe this snake knows very well where he is, just like all the animals I've been working with over the years. They know exactly where they're going, what they're doing, and what time they have to get to certain places for certain activities that they have to do. He's still stationary. What he's doing is the rat snake's equivalent of what the rattlesnake does. When you find a rattlesnake in the wild, they typically lay motionless until you pass. His tactic is, if he stays perfectly still, you might think he's a stick, and then you'll just walk right past him. You know, this is the very first time he's been found on the floor of the forest. This is just really cool stuff here. Weather, does anybody see any clouds at all in the sky?
No.
So it's clear, calm. Did it rain last night here?
I don't think so. Maybe, yeah, I don't think so. Maybe it's
visible. Yeah. Yep, he's moving. Okay, he's on the move. I'm gonna have to grab him. Here he is. Just want to get a good look at him with the camera here. Because as soon as I pick him up, it's gonna be quick. We're only gonna get to pick him up for just a couple of minutes while you guys take a look at him. Okay, so I'm gonna pick up Splinter. We're gonna check him out real quick, give him a good physical. And then take him over here and let the students see him and then let him go. We're gonna do it really quick. We'll try to weigh him, can't guarantee anything. No, no, you're all right, you're all right. Here he comes. You can stay right there, that's good. So here's Splinter, and he looks beautiful. Looks like he's in excellent shape.
Better than he was when he got released.
A lot better, a lot shinier. You can even see that swelling on the left side of his head, the left side of his nose there, is gone pretty much.
Well, he seems a lot perkier.
He does, doesn't he?
Yeah, he was pretty lazy when you first released him.
Think about this, he had been in hibernation all winter. So, he's doing great. He feels heavier too. And look, he's still the nicest snake. He's not being aggressive at all. Very cool snake. Looks great. All right, so let's try to weigh him. He's gonna hate this. He hates pillowcases. I've had to put him in pillowcases before, and he doesn't like them. All right. Where's the scale? Sweet. Okay, I don't want this to spin. Okay, yep. Yeah, we're not gonna be. He's over 1,000 grams. We're not gonna be able to weigh him. That's good though. That means he's doing well, he's healthy. All right. Okay, you can come out of here. Sorry. You can touch them just gently. This is a wild rat snake, guys. Now, of course, don't go picking up wild snakes in the woods on your own, because you might pick one up who's not as nice as Scar. Very cool. So we're not even going to bother setting up that camera because he's on the move. If he was in a tree, we would set it up. All right, let's let him go. Time to let him go. Let him get back to his important snake business. And I'll let him go exactly where I found him. He knows where he is. And he knows exactly where he is because his tongue's working really fast. He's sniffing the ground, and now I'm sure he realizes exactly where he is, and he's going to go on about his important business. Does anybody know what the important business of a rat snake would be?
Eating rats.
Eat rats and mice and squirrels. Rabbits, birds, bats. That's exactly right. And look at that. He's not even fleeing, you know, really fast. He's just slowly moving off. But you can tell the direction he's going is away from us. He doesn't really want to have anything to do with humans. I'm almost done here, guys. Just getting the last little bit of this video footage. It's really awesome. Because, you know, I may not see them again till it's like September. You never know. Because they're so arboreal, they spend so much time in the trees. It's really hard to get a good look at them. And when we get the chance, we have to take it. And he's gone. He's all stretched out down there. You can still see him if you look over here. But he's not in a hurry. If he does things in a hurry, he uses way too much energy. And that's one thing reptiles are good at, and that's conserving energy. All right. Now I need to finish my data collection, and we're gonna head back. All right, so we found Splinter. And he was on the forest floor moving along. That's just really awesome. Great data. And he is moving off into the forest now. He looked very healthy, and that's really good. So let's leave him alone now and get back out of these forests. Good job, guys.
All right.
Cool.